there's a few names I want to call out, but there's this one guy that's been chatting a lot of shit, man. And I'm going to call him out. He's a big dude. He got muscles. And just because you got muscles don't mean you can box. And I'm going to prove that really, really soon. So Faze temperr. Where you at, boy? You want to get slept next? I'm going to show you, son. I'm going to show you this boxing shit is real, bro. I put in that work. This man got a boxing bag in his backyard. He thinks he's a boxer now. I'm going to work him, bro. I promise you that.
That's it from God, honestly. It's like written. Everything was written. Like, this is my moment. Like, I had to, like, take this moment, bro. Because I know if I never took this opportunity, he'll never want to fight me. I've been chasing.
Why do you say that?
Because I've been chasing him since October. And I called, literally my last fight, I said, temperr, where you at, boy? That's exactly what I said. Because he was telling people I didn't want to fight him. He was telling people that.
Because you did it. Because you did it.
Then why did I say temperr, where you at, boy? Why did
I say that? When the opportunity came for you to fight me, 2 weeks later, you declined. You're like, no, he needs to be 20 pounds underweight.
No, I'm talking about, we got to meet him.
You told the commission.
We can't box each other if we're not in the same weight class, bro. I'm coming up to your weight too, by the way. I'm coming up to your weight. Everything's your way. You know what I'm saying? You the diva. You know what I'm saying? We might give you some bras and panties. You may get in WWE, whatever the fuck you want to do, bro. But yo, I'm ready, bro. Whatever you want to bring. Everything's on your terms, bro. Everything's on your terms. What's your excuse? I have 2 weeks, no strength and condition, no nothing, bro.
I have no excuse, bro.
You have no excuse.
You could have a full camp and you're still going to get your ass whooped.
Nah, don't say that, bro.
Nah, I mean that.
If I had a full camp, it would have been worse. But it's all good.
I mean,
because I have enough skill. I know when it comes to technique, I'm better than you. When it comes to footwork, I'm better than you. When it comes to speed, I'm faster.
You don't know shit, bro, because I don't
got
post shit.
It's 6'4". That's
you
it.
Don't know shit.
6'4". That's what I think all you got.
You're just a loudmouth, you're stupid as fuck, and you don't know nothing.
Yo, man, just put something on that shelf. That's what you're good at, I think, honestly. You're very talented at putting things on shelves. He's 6'4" for nothing. I just think, you know what I'm saying? Like, if
you
I
say that, what do you mean? You said I that think, before. What do you mean?
This is what I mean. Like, if I was 6'4", I wouldn't choose to sit on my ass and play Call of Duty with my life. Like, you know, I'll be in the NBA or some shit. That's the way I see it, bro.
I can
you
literally
know
dunk
mean?
On you.
Nah, you can't dunk on me.
I can literally dunk
basketball,
on you.
You yeah. not, bro, basketball, you would not. I'm telling you, bro, that's what I used to do, bro. That's
and
what I used to
shit
really.
On you. I don't even play basketball, and I'll shit on you in basketball.
Nah, you would not, bro.
Bro, you could take any sport.
I would take any
sport.
Not.
Basketball,
no, no,
soccer,
no, not any
football.
Sport. Don't say that, bro. No,
any sport.
Basketball,
bro.
That was my first love, bro. I'm telling you, that's what I used to play AAU basketball. That's what I used to really, really do, bro. That's why I got footwork, man, and everything. That's the reason my boxing, my footwork transitioned because basketball. Like, that was my love. Like, I actually balled out Brooklyn. I used to travel from Brooklyn, play state to state and shit. Like, that's what I used to do. So that's what I'm saying. Like, I play sports just because people think because of my goofy attitude, thinks they don't play. I play sports and stuff, but this is what I do, man. I love it, bro. So like, I transition into boxing, and that's it.
I catch a fast break, bro. You're getting dunked on.
Nah, hell no.
100%. He reminds me of a chihuahua.
Nah, come
How
on,
so?
Bro.
How
really?
So?
Like
a, not even a pit bull. not even a Doberman. Come on, man. Like come on. Yo, what's going on, bro? This man coming to Chihuahua, bro? Come on.
You're saying
bro.
He has a lot of bark but no bite type of
no,
thing.
No, don't say that. Come on, bro. Three KOs is, come on, three
That's
KOs.
That's what Chihuahuas is, bro.
Three KOs, bro.
Wait, you
come
didn't
on.
Even KO Fusi. You just won.
KO, I broke his nose, bro. He spent 20K on surgery. What are you talking about? Who else done that? Who else in the whole
that's
YouTube
not,
boxing
that's
scene
a TKO.
Broke a face?
It's Who, not a KO.
Tell me, wait. Has anybody in the whole YouTube boxing scene broke someone's face? With head guard on.
Bro. Not with
head guard. Has someone else knocked someone out with 14-ounce gloves on? 14-ounce gloves.
He didn't even know how to defend
and under
himself.
Under three rounds, 2 minutes.
He defended himself with his head.
I know, but listen. Has anybody knocked someone else out with 14-ounce gloves? 14-ounce gloves.
I don't know, bro.
Have you dropped someone with sparring with 16-ounce gloves, person? Have you ever dropped someone sparring that knows how to move?
Yeah,
you know
I
what
have.
Saying? Come on, bro. Don't lie. I seen some of your clips, bro. You dropping kids that fucking throw like swimming punches, bro.
What are you talking
honestly.
About?
And then the head movement clip, he posted.
I don't even post my clips.
For someone his size, bro, he's not that good. I think he's overhyped. He's super overhyped. People,
what are the holes you see? Because you've kind of said this already.
Bro, he has a huge hole in his defense. Yo, Wally, have you worked on his defense? You gotta work on his defense, man. I'm telling you, defense, bro. Your defense is weak. I'm telling you, he has a huge hole in his defense.
Where do you see that? What is that from the Kenny fight you're
taking
a look
at? Yeah, the Kenny fight, yes. Yeah, the big
what time. Happened there that you saw?
I mean, you saw in the fourth round. We saw in the fourth round when we had a little pressure on him. He didn't know what to do. He's on the ropes like this. He's on the ropes like this with his hands down and shit, chin up in the air.
I still won that exchange.
I mean, yo, bro, but that's with Kenny. That's not with me, man. I'm a different fighter.
No, that was 5 months
ago.
That was 5.5 months ago.
Nah, was it 5 months ago?
5.5 months ago.
I know, man, but still, I don't think that's enough time, bro.
You think I've just been chilling?
I put time into this craft, bro. I put time into my craft.
I put time and quality into this shit, bro.
Okay, I can't wait to see what you bring on Saturday night, bro. I'm excited, actually.
Nah, for sure.
I'm really excited because I throw when tensions to kill, bro. I'm telling you, son, you're gonna feel real power and real pop. I don't think you have pop in your punches too. All right. You got no whip in your punches.
Yeah, yeah, we're gonna see.
We'll find out. We'll find out.
We're gonna see.
I'm excited.
I don't know. I see a toothpick for an arm. So I love that. I don't know how much power you can really generate from that.
I actually love that.
You know, I know it's not about muscles in boxing at all.
You think so?
But like, you light as a feather, my boy.
You think so? I love that. You know, I love that's the beauty of this, man. That's the beauty of boxing, man. I love that people, when they see me, they see like a frail, skinny guy. But yo, you're gonna be the guy stepping in the room. You're gonna find out how light this feather punches, bro, or how hard this feather punches. You're gonna find out. I'm telling you, you're gonna be scared to exchange with me.
Just like I told Kenny, bro, you're gonna have a hard time trying to touch me.
Nah. Don't say that. I'm not Kenny, boy. I'm telling you, I got way more weapons up my sleeve than Kenny. Kenny was just still.
The difference between you and Kenny is you're going to sleep.
Nah.
Night, night.
Nah.
Night, night, my boy.
I don't think there's a better.
You're funny as fuck, bro. I mean, this was hilarious.
I always woke up with a smile on my face, no matter how difficult the situation was. I was, you know what? I know Allah has a better plan for me. I know. And when I got that phone call from Mams Taylor to take this fight with Faze Temper, I know it's destiny, and I know it's gonna be destiny on Saturday night when I come in and knock his head off. But Saturday night, yo, Tommy boy, let's put this in Call of Duty terms. Yo, Tommy boy. I'm bringing my Tommy, boy. And on Saturday night, I'm going to strip for y'all right now. I'm going to be Ebu Faze. Ebu Faze in the building, boy. If for the non-Arabs in the building, Ebu Faze means father of. So I'm going to be the father of Faze, basically. Thank you very much.
Slim, I just want to remind you the reason you're here today is because I chose you to be here.
What?
I literally chose you to be here, bro.
You chose me to be here?
Yeah.
No, you didn't, bro. My last fight, literally... I was supposed to fight him on Social Knockout 2, my third fight, right? He didn't want to cut down to my weight, so I ended up fighting some other dude. And then he was telling everybody, yo, Slim is ducking me, yo. So you know what I did? After I knocked out my last opponent, I put him to sleep. The hospital came and everything. Like, he was out for like 10 minutes. Is that serious? Y'all can watch the clip, bro. You know what I'm saying? I literally called him out. This is what I said. You can see. I said, Faze Temper, where you at, boy? And Mams Taylor was calling me, who you want to fight? I said, give me Faze Temper. Everybody that contacted me, I'm like, give me Faze Temper. If I didn't take this opportunity, he would never, ever want to fight me, bro. So he has the two-week advantage. No strength and conditioning. No nothing, bro. I'm coming in. I know when it comes to straight boxing ability, I'm way better than him. I got better technique than you. I'm faster than you. I have better footwork than you. All you is 6'4". That's it. You 6'4" for nothing. You 6'4" to put shit on shelves. That's it. That's what I think.
Yo, you could have a full camp and you still wouldn't.
Nah.
You could have a full camp, bro.
Nah.
Pounds for the hitman. 171 pounds for Faze Temper.
Roddy, better catch a body. Before I touch dirt,
I'll kill your cow. Catch me in my Mercedes, bumping ice, ice, baby, screaming shady till I die. Like I have a paradise, life's crazy, so I live it till the fullest, till I'm Swayze, and you only live it once. So I'm thinking about this nice land, and wait, don't stop me now before I get on a roll. Let me tell you what this pretty little dame's name is, cause she's kinda famous, and I hope that I don't sound too heinous when I say this. Nicki Minaj, what I wanna stick my penis in your anus. You morons think that I'm a genius, really I belong inside a dang insane asylum. Cana drive them trailer parks crazy, I am back and I am razor sharp. Baby in this back with a capital B with an exclamation mark. Maybe you should listen when I flip the linguistics, cause when I rip this mystical slick shit, you don't wanna become another victim or statistic of this shit. Cause after I spit the bullets, I'ma treat these shell cakes like a soccer ball. I'ma kick the ballistics, so get this dick, I'ma lift this.
Life in the fast lane, moving at the speed of life and I can't slow down. Only got a gallon in the gas tank, but I'm almost at the finish line, so I can't stop now. I don't really know where I'm headed, just enjoying the ride. Just gonna roll till I drop and ride till I die. I'm living life in the fast lane.
My whole goal is a poet's to be relaxed in orbit at war with a bottle as Captain Morgan attacks my organs. My slow flow is.
And tomorrow I'm gonna catch another body. 4-0, 4 KOs. Let's get it, baby. Let's go.
You let me take a shovel, dig up the corpse of Jack of Orchid. Go back and forfeit more beef than you can pack a fork in. I'm living the life of the infinite enemy down. My tenement chimney now. The semi serenity pal. Spin him around. Entering in the vicinity.
Now it's calling him in, but he threw it a canning and ate the rap. I chewed him up and spitted him out. Girl, get it up, now get it down. He's looking around, it's clubbing. It looks like people are having a shit. Now, yeah, little